this video, we will be demonstrating one of TecQuipment's subsonic wind tunnels, the AF1300. This compact, freestanding, open-circuit suction subsonic wind tunnel allows students to study low-speed aerodynamic effects at undergraduate level and for research projects. Today, we're in the Mechanical Engineering Laboratory at Nottingham Trent University. This subsonic wind tunnel is part of a range of wind tunnels and aerodynamic experiments, all designed by TecQuipment for teaching aerodynamics. The range of models available for use with the AF1300 allows students to investigate boundary layers, carry out flow visualization, and perform investigations involving velocity and the wake. The AF1300 is 3.7 metres long and has a working section of 305 millimetres by 305 millimetres and 600 millimetres long. The lockable wheels on a single frame mounted unit allows it to easily be pushed to the corner when not in use, particularly if space is at a premium. The air enters the tunnel through an aerodynamically designed effuser, also known as a contraction cone. This accelerates the air in a linear manner. It then passes through a honeycomb flow straightener and enters the working section, then passing through a grill before moving through a diffuser and then to the variable speed axial fan. The air leaves the fan and passes through a silencer unit and then back out into the atmosphere. The speed of the axial fan that is creating the air velocity within the working section can be varied using the separate control instrumentation unit, as seen here. This is mounted on an instrument frame, which can also accommodate many of the optional ancillaries. The control panel also includes two manometers that can be used to measure the fore and aft pressures from the pitot-static tubes or other devices. In addition, up to two optional differential feedback units can be fitted to the control panel to measure and display the differential pressures from the subsonic wind tunnel pitot tubes or model tappings. Looking at the working section in more detail, it has a square cross section made up of an acrylic roof, sides and floor, supported by an aluminium framework. The sides can be removed for setting experiments, with each side featuring a holder to support the optional wind tunnel models. On top of the working section are two holes for pitot devices and two wall tappings to measure the static pressure upstream and downstream the working section. If the basic lift and drag balance is used with a wind tunnel, lift and drag can be measured. Alternatively, there's a three-component balance that you can see here, which will give additional measurement of moment. For accurate and real-time data capture, monitoring and display, calculation and charting of all important readings, TecQuipment's versatile data acquisition system can be used with a suitable separate computer. The wind tunnel is available to purchase either on its own or as a starter set, including the basic lift and drag balance and a set of three-dimensional drag models. TecQuipment also manufacture a large range of optional ancillaries for the AF1300. For more information about subsonic wind tunnels and other products in the aerodynamics range from TecQuipment, click on the link in the description box below. Thank you for watching.